Hello everyone and welcome to another video from the depths. And yep, this is a helicopter. And oh boy, I thought that making that submarine was complicated. This thing has been a nightmare. But it works! I'm happy, happy, happy again. There have been a lot of complications, however, and it doesn't really behave like a proper helicopter. Let me explain that in a second. Let's bring the UI back on. Now, the first thing is that helicopters in from the depths, from what I have found, because I did a lot of search for making this video properly, helicopters in from the depths don't work the way real helicopters work. In real life, a helicopter will have a rotor, main rotor, and a tail rotor, or like this one, a counter-rotating propeller. These are actually rotating opposite each other. Now, a real helicopter achieves movement through tilting these rotors. So if you want to move forward, you tilt the blades a little bit forward, you gain a little bit momentum, you pitch the nose down, and as the blade is inclined towards the vertical, you get a forward component and you accelerate that way. The same way to move sideways, the same thing to move backwards, etc. Rotation and yaw you achieve by changing the blade lift, so you achieve in the rotor or on these ones. In the coaxial ones, for instance, well, you know that as something rotates, you tend to rotate the other way. Coaxial rotors, what they do is one rotates one way, one the other one, and they counter each other. So when you are trying to yaw, what you do is to reduce the lift one of those produces, increase the other, you give the lift total lift stable, and then you yaw in the direction of the propeller that is turning, the opposite to the propeller that is turning with more force. In conventional helicopters with one rotor and a tail one, you increase or decrease the lift that tail rotor produces, so you get a yaw. And to roll, what you do is to increase cyclically the pitch of one of the sides. So if this side is making more lift than this side, then the helicopter will roll that way. And opposite, if you increase the lift of this one, this will roll the other way. Well, that's how a helicopter works. The problem is in that from the depths, from where, again, what I understand, you only get a vertical component out of these blades. So you can't tilt them either forwards or backwards or sideways, so you're stuck. If you only put this, well, you're going to up and go up. And then start tilting some other way, because you can almost, it's almost impossible to perfectly center it alongside the center of mass, because it's really important to have your lift vector from the rotors aligned with your center of mass, because otherwise you will be creating moments and your helicopter will be totally out of balance. But this is not perfectly aligned, I mean, it's in the proper block, you can see that, but even a millimeter causes the helicopter to start losing control backwards or forwards, depending if it's forwards or backwards. And to help with that, I have to use jet stabilizers, and it's not that I like it, but it's what you have to do, because otherwise you are out of control. And another thing, in order to move, I have to place proper thrusters. You can't move backwards, you can't move sideways with this helicopter, because simply the rotors, you can't tilt them. If you could tilt them, those things would be unnecessary, the helicopter would fly on its own. But I had to compromise in order to do a working helicopter, even while I'm losing a lot of the helicopter traits, of course. But still, it works. It has rotors, it flies, and gets stuff done. Now, doing this video is going to be complicated, because this thing is super complex. These are the components in small size. You can see the thing is packed with things. It's totally full of components. There's no space in there to show you anything. I mean, if I go normal and I move in here, well, this is the engine area, but Yeah, you get what I mean, right? I mean, you're not going to see a lot here, so I'm going to try to explain you what this helicopter does, and that will be it. I mean, more or less, explain to you the layout from the outside, because in the inside you're going to see nothing at all. So first, the cockpit. Now, the cockpit, obviously, is where the pilot stands. Well, the glasses are a little bit too tinted. I should have to lighten them a little bit, but they look cool from the outside. At any rate, I'm not going to be flying from in here. So, these two are the altitude controllers. In the very, very similar way as I did with the submarine, instead of affecting air pumps, this affects the spin blocks, which are the rotors. And in order to increase altitude, I increase the RPM. In order to decrease it, I decrease it. I'm keeping this helicopter between 300 meters and 280 meters. Now here I have a pretty nice little thing I found while feeding out this helicopter. This is, I don't know how it's called, but it's a remote controller. And with this you can control drones, but you also can control wireless cameras. And I have two of those here. One of them is the forward vigilance one. This is mounted just in the top of the helicopter, in front of the spinning blades or the rotor, and well, it's to see far. I mean, you are seeing beyond the horizon here, but when this thing moves forward, it tilts forward so you can see what's over there with a lot of zoom. And then you have the mini one. And is that this is obviously because I have a turret. I can actually control the turret from here, and also fire from here. I mean, the crosshair doesn't move, but as you can see, I can fire from here, which is pretty cool. I mean, it's mostly a thing to. It's cool, it doesn't really work for anything else, but whatever. Yeah, here I have a fire control computer, so I can't I can guide and fire all my guns from the cockpit, because I can't move out of the cockpit. Obviously, in a helicopter you are not moving around the engine compartment. Here is a slightly armored backrest, but yeah. The helicopter is integrally made of light alloys. So it really doesn't stand a lot of gunfire. It's very vulnerable. But well, a little, I mean, this I guess will help a little bit, I don't know. I might later on add more stuff here, more armor or whatever, but if I have equipment here, why not here? I'll see. I don't know what I could put here that would be cool, but something can be put here. Now, from the outside, let's start with the front side. Air camera for detection, a visual camera for visual detection, a radar tracker. This is not a search tool, but rather a tracking tool to improve accuracy. Then a lot of weapon detectors for the flares. Now here we have a 27mm triple barrel Gatling gun. Fires pretty fast. That's a decent amount of recoil, but not too much, so I can fire it constantly and the helicopter won't lose altitude. This took me a little bit of time to properly configure, so the helicopter was stable enough, because it's mounted much lower than the center of mass, so obviously, yeah. If you are firing forwards and downwards, no big problem, because your recoil goes through the center of mass. But if you are firing sideways, this thing in the first tryouts was spinning out of control. But yeah, I added some recoil features. I toyed with the different configurations of caliber and etc. to make it big enough to be really, 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 really nice, while not being big enough to make me get out of the helicopter in a tumbling roll. Okay, up here, three air flare launchers. These are for defense and spoofing enemy missiles. Now here we have quadruple twin, of course, one in each wing. Quadruple laser-guided anti-ground missiles. And I have them set intentionally to fire only to ground targets. I think here. Minimum altitude, top altitude. I mean, these are only for ships, land structures, whatever I can find, but not against enemy aircraft, because laser guidance is not really good against enemy aircraft. Here, however, I have a couple of short-range air guided missiles. These are, obviously, configured to shoot aircraft targets only. Minimum altitude to engage 50 meters, so it won't shoot at ground targets. And upper limit, no limit, so it will engage air targets only. Okay, that's all the fire control stuff. What's more? Well, I added a little bit of ballast here with lead to keep the center of mass a little lower, because it was the first time it was a little bit too high. This is very light, by the way. Light alloys are really, really, really light. Right wing is the same as the left wing. Now here I have the thrusters, kind of imitating the exhaust of a proper helicopter. Yeah, initially when I thought I could be able to make a proper helicopter without thrusters, I had the engine exhaust deep in here, so it would be hidden within this structure, which is what the real helicopters do. They hide the exhaust behind structures, so, and try to mask the air signature. Of course, I wasn't able to do that because I needed thrusters, but still, well, I think it's quite neat looking. Back here we have the rear detection section with more munition warning systems, some more passive detectors, visual cameras, passive radar, retro deflection detectors on the sides. This is to give first a secondary ability to keep the targets detected in case the nose gets blown off, or even if the rear, because this thing, thankfully, as it has twin rotors, can stay aloft with the tail blown off, giving time for repairs to happen. It's not going to fly very well, but it's going to stay in the air. Back here, well, we have the... I don't know why this keep on tilting upwards each time I come here. I mean, it's not a big issue, because in vertical they also do, but I always put them... Hold on a second. Copy and... Tilt. And put them as they should be, like a proper tailplane, for pitch control. And behind here, a tailplane with the inevitable thruster to keep some yaw control. Really, I couldn't do anything about it, simply. I needed this. And this is on the outside. In the inside, well, the cockpit area ends up roughly here. From here to roughly here, the engine compartment, which is roughly 1100 power. I'm going to try to show you the stats. Pretty efficient, I think. It has a pretty constant power per unit of fuel all across the board. It has several superchargers, several carburetors, and well, carburetors, of course, several turbos and several superchargers. So, yeah, it's quite efficient for the size, I think. At least it's the most efficient thing I could fit in the here, so yeah. While being powerful enough, because I use all this power for seals when I'm in combat. Back here, well, from this frame to roughly here, where the fuel tank is going to be, here. That's the AI storage zone, the ammunition storage. I also have the ammunition producers for the gun back here. And, well, here's the fuel tank. And from here back, well, AI connectors for the detection, and then I crammed the insides with all the ammo parts I could, some repair bots, some obviously the PIDs to keep this thing stable, the controllers, the automated controllers for things like the seals and that kind of stuff. It's all in crammed here, but really I can't give you a proper guide because, yes, It's pretty cool, actually. Let's move a little bit forwards. As you can see, it pitches down when it starts moving, which actually is a lot like real helicopters. But the problem, obviously, is that sadly, it doesn't do all the things helicopters do, like, well, being able to rotate on the spot, being able to, because I need forward thrust. The only pitch yaw control I have is this, and this little thruster that doesn't help a lot. So I need forward movement in order to yaw, otherwise I won't yaw. Same with pitch control, it's quite complicated. Well, pitch is less complicated actually. Pitch I can keep pretty steady, but this helped quite a little bit. Now, what else? Well, it turns through pure yawing, no rolling involved, because trying to roll this thing ends up in spins. Again, because the blades are rotating in the same plane. I really wish I could have done this up the proper way, but I didn't know how. So, well, at least it works. It's like a proper helicopter, looks like a proper helicopter, and quite fights like a proper helicopter. So let's start the pyrotechnics. Yeah, it's why you are looking at this. Come on, you want to see me shooting stuff. So, okay, let's, first of all, I'm going to keep a little bit of forward momentum, switch the
taking control
combat on, and bring, let's start with a marauder. And the way I do this, I could do this through automated control, but I'm actually, where is it? There, far away there. Okay, let's, it's already turning towards that way. And what did, okay. So we are going that way, is there, he's already firing, by the way. If one of those shots hits me, I'm going to be disgraced. I need to be under 1,000 meters in order to start shooting missiles. This is going to hit? No. I need to be under 1,000 meters to start shooting missiles. I have the gun set for 6,000 meters, more or less, is the effective range. And obviously the higher missiles are not going to shoot, because they are only for aero attacks. As you can see, I have the seals set up for proper attack from the frontal position. Covering the bottom, covering the front with high angles involved, that hopefully will mean I'm going to bounce a lot of cells in case they actually connect with me. Hopefully they don't connect at all, but whatever. Okay, so let's move close to the enemy, because I like to guide my weapons. Okay, missiles are incoming, let's guide them towards the bow. There goes that gun! Ha ha ha! Yeah, you can do that! Wait for the AI to drop the missiles and then guide the laser to the exact impact point you want. More missiles. Okay, now the Gatling is firing. So what I'm going to do is to aim at the bridge and fire at the bridge. Obviously, it's not a lot of damage per shot, but it's a lot of shots. This thing has a... how's it called? A clip with ammo belts. So after it fires everything, it takes maybe a minute to start firing again. But yeah, you can see it's turning that bridge into a... yeah, a garden, more or less. Seems that the gun is out of ammo. So let's guide these missiles. Look at that, it's amazing. Okay, where am I? I'm going to wait for them to be reloaded and then I will fire them manually. Okay, something is firing back. Or it's me. No, it's me! Okay, let's fire here. And I don't know what's in here. The engine. Let's kill the engine of this thing. And you can see I'm hovering all around the place while delivering mortal blows to this thing. Yeah, the engine is looking really black, that means it's really damaged. Now I'm starting to blast it away. More stuff incoming. Okay, cannon reloading. Let's try to guide a missile in here. Okay, engine is gone. Next target, the bridge. Here it comes. Hey! Okay, that was being guided by the other laser. I have them on common guidance, but I think... yeah, one of the lasers is pointing there because, as you can see, it's out of gimbal. But these missiles are guiding properly. The ones that come from the left, they guide to the left laser. Now they should all come here, because I have both lasers on the same position. Yeah. There's something moving in there. That's a soldier. Oh, that's cool. That's an enemy. I didn't know they were moving enemies in this game. Well, not anymore. Okay, back to the... Okay, the gun is reloading. Yeah, I think I could safely say this thing is going to go down. Now, where's the AI? I don't have a clue. I think this engine is still producing a little bit of power. So let's try to guide some missiles here. Yeah. And that killed the AI too. That's super fun! I mean, this thing can do things automatically, of course. I mean, I could keep it in automated, but I love picking my targets and well, destroying enemy guns, destroying enemy big parts, the important parts, and then proceeding to sink him. Let's give it another try, see something different. And well, no, actually, let's wait a little bit so my ammo reserves are refilled. It's going to take a while because obviously missiles are ammo hungry. I only have 8 of them. They are not especially big, but after two, three salvos, yeah, as you can see, well, I'm already building my reserves up, but it's going to be a while, so be right back. Okay, I think I built enough of a reserve. Let's bring something different. Now that was a marauder, let's bring a Kalmar. Kalmar looks nice. Where is it? It's behind. Okay, so we are going to turn around, doing so automatically. Obviously, all the flying I have configured in the AI settings. It does fly alone, it fights alone if I want him to. But I like, again, guiding my weapons. So let's come here. Once we see the lasers and the missiles, we will try to guide them. Another dude with big guns. And these are a lot of guns, not just two. Where am I? There. Moving into engage, waggling a little bit, which is good. Again coming. Are missiles coming? Missiles are coming. Okay, switch guidance. Okay. One of the guns is this grazer, but it's just one. That thing has pretty decent armor, and if I get hit, it's going to be painful. So let's hope I don't get hit. Okay, those are not guiding where I told them to. Cannon is online. On the turret, please. Ooh, that was close. Really need to shoot this gun off. One of the guns is almost destroyed, but the other one is still shooting very big. And has very big elevation. Ooh, okay, that one passed. Yeah, it seems we destroyed the turret controls. Gonna make sure. Okay, now we are hitting the mass because it's in the way. But yeah, we pretty much hollowed out this ship. It's going down already. Wow, that was effective. Hey, go me. Well done, guys. Yeah, you can see the turret is tracking my cursor. Let's put it in auto and bring it forward. Go me, that was fast. This thing is really, really good. The problem is, if you get hit, it's a done deal. I mean, I have seals, they deflect some shots, but those that go through, they especially because they have so much stuff crammed in here. If I get hit in the wing, I don't really care. That's going to get repaired. If I get hit in the nose, eh, no big deal. I mean, most of the nose is covered with seals. This thing I can do without because I have a double set of sensors back here. But if I missile hits in the center, it's game over. Game over, man! Game over. Okay, we have enough munitions. Okay, let's spawn something different. Sinners, luck. River home. River home! This thing we also Oyeko's folly. Tugboat. My tugboat doesn't sound very well. Rear home. This we saw in other episodes. Let's use this one. And it's behind us, so it's going to switch. Seal sound. Turn merrily around. Let's go there. So when the missiles come, we can guide them to what do we want to shoot. Ooh, this turret. This turret up here has to go. Okay. Here we come. Shots fired. Missiles incoming. Guidance. Oh, lots of misses. That wasn't good. Okay. Missiles are coming again. Come on. Okay, some hits in there, but not enough. Cannon, make me proud. More to the front. There. Ooh, that looks. Oof! I blasted through the enemy. Oof! But yeah. Okay, this turret is gone. It's capsizing! This ship is capsizing? Yes, it's turning turtle. Look at that hole! Holy shit! Oh my gosh! Okay, so much for being dangerous. Holy crap, that was amazing. Okay, let's try to guide some missiles to the rear. I don't know why they are not guiding. It's totally upside down. That was amazing. Yeah, now the missiles come. Let's start hammering in here because the engine is down here. Yeah, that autocannon is really, really useful. Has very high penetration. The Saber round has 19 penetration, something like that. It goes through no matter what. The explosive one obviously doesn't. But as I have a proper mixture of both, the effects are combined. Okay, let's start shooting back here because the engine block is here. I mean, not that this guy is going to ride himself anytime soon because he has no hull. AI dead, AI dead. Okay. All stations, we can call this array. I don't think I have ever seen this. Let's try it out. Okay, it's behind us. Let me take a close look. I already fought that. River home. Cine Slack. Let's see what this is. Ooh, it's in front of us! Can we. Oh, has a turret here! Not in time, not in time. We didn't manage to. Okay, I'm here. Whatever you do, don't get shot. Ooh, nice avoidance here. This is coming. Yes! I think we got it! Oh, that shot! That shot! That was close. And I think he still has. Okay, gun. Hit here. Open that place up. Meanwhile, yeah. Torvet is still operational, but we are on top of him. He can't aim at us right now. The problem is we are reloading the turret. He can't fire this up! Wow, that was close! Okay, he sure has some elevation to those guns. Am I hitting the proper spot? Not really, because I'm turning. And obviously my accuracy is suffering. Now we are hitting target again. I think we need. Ooh, that was great. Ooh, okay, nice jump. We need to hit here. As soon as we have missiles. Holy shit, that gun elevation, man. Yes, 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 yes. One gun is still operational, however. She's still fighting back. You fight here. That's missed? It missed. Come on, we are so close killing it. Keeping the aiming point here. He also has some elevation and not elevation. I mean, holy shit, that thing. Okay, guns, engage this, please. Okay, we are working the turret now. If I get hit now, I'm going to be pissed. Okay, turret seems out of order. Now hit here then. Actually, as soon as you have. There, make sure it goes down. Turret here. Come on, destroy that. Not those ammo bags and crates. He's dead in the water. Shouldn't last long, but I want that turret dead. Yeah. We are pulling through, we are pulling through, we are pulling through. Not very accurate with this gun, however. Come on. Yeah, yes, yes, yes. Okay, let's try to put a missile here. If we can. There! And as soon as you. No, it's despawning. Wow! Okay, that was complicated. But we won! We won. Some shots came so close, man. Oof. And yeah, this thing can't really take a shot. But well, this is my helicopter. It works. I'm super happy with it. And I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much for watching, guys, and see you later. And yeah, I know, for the purists out there, the Hokum, the KA-50 doesn't have a turret. It has a 30mm cannon. That's why I also have a version with one, which honestly doesn't work as well, because arsenal fire limitation, and also recoil out of the center of mass. But if you want that, you can get us that as well. So yeah. And now, yes, thank you very much for watching, and see you later.